Hey, you spooks and spookers. I'm Jen Houston. Welcome to Shut Your Cake Hole, where we talk about cakes, cakes, and cakes. So I opened up a very old trunk that I packed away in my probably early teens, and it was filled with dolls. Some of them had battery acid dripping down the backs of them. So I've been thinking a lot about haunted dolls. And I was inspired by the movie in which I star called Evil Sublet, which has a haunted doll theme running through it.
What you have here is what is commonly referred to as a creepy fucking doll.
I wanted to join the ranks of the haunted doll makers. So let's get started. So I have made a few different sizes of a black velvet cake, which I am going to fill with black raspberry cocoa buttercream. I'm adding some black raspberry syrup. Just because she's haunted doesn't mean she shouldn't taste good. I'm gonna chill this down. Just took a square board and covered it with some Tylose-infused fondant, so it'd be nice and firm, and gave it a few rough wood impressions. I'm gonna get with my watercolors and do my magic. And I'm gonna take a damp paper towel and I'm going to wipe a lot of it away. All I was trying to do with that was to get the black to leave itself in those crevices. All right, I'm gonna let that dry. Baby doll's body, she's definitely firm enough to cut. Basically, I just need a rough shape before she slips any further. Give her a bamboo skewer and just lock those layers into place. All right, I think I can give her a coat in ganache.
Oh man.
Mm-mm-mm. Stay. I have mounted a little styrofoam craft ball onto a washed piece of PVC pipe. I could have used Rice Krispie Treats and I could have made the whole thing edible, but I also knew that I probably wanted to keep this at the end forever and ever and ever. And I'm going to melt some marshmallows. Now I can just roll out some of this white fondant, which I have made. I think I'll go ahead and press some eyes. All right, I am gonna do what I usually do and make some isomalt eyes. If you want to see the very first time I made isomalt eyes, you can refer back to The Leprechaun. First, I need a little clear isomalt. And just move that around a little bit. A tiny drop of black, and that's gonna be the pupil. And I'm gonna let that cool down a little bit before I pour the final color on top of that, which is gonna be kind of a milky blue dead eye thing.
A pale blue eye with a film over it. Whenever it fell upon me, my blood ran cold.
Take a little white watercolor. All right, let's put the eyes in. I'm going to start building up some of her features with some modeling chocolate. Eyes out. Now we can do the sculpt. Wire up there so I can make her ponytails more buoyant. All right, it is time to transfer our baby doll body onto our cake board. Get everything food safe. I already washed my dowel. I'm covering everything else up in aluminum foil tape. Just gonna give myself some shoulders. I need to make some legs. So I'm going to use 50% Fonet and 50% modeling chocolate. I'll take these cake scraps and make a little cake clay and give her some shoulders. I'm gonna cover at least the top half of her in some Fonet. Little tool and give her some stitch marks on the hem of her dress. Transfer her head onto this body. I'm gonna come back tomorrow and we will finish her up nighty night. All right, you guys, let's finish this thing up. I'm making her collar. I just embossed this piece of fondant with my little lace mold. A dressmaker, I am not. Hopefully she will really come to life now. Little sugar pearls. Let me make her hands. I had a doll called Busy Lizzie, and she was a maid. Then I had another two dolls that danced, one called Swingy, and the other was called Dancerina. All right, I am gonna start painting her, which is what's gonna take her from being ever so slightly cute to being perhaps a bit tragic. If I am making a cake for a client, I am masked and gloved the entire time. Things are very different now. She's starting to look a little gothy and sad. Some walls so we could see that she's in a room. You guys, I'm done with my haunted doll locked in the attic cake. We made our doll out of black velvet cake with black raspberry cocoa buttercream and dark chocolate ganache as the glue, and covered her in modeling chocolate and homemade fondant and some watercolor and some airbrush. Slightly different technique on the eyes, made of isomalt, which is fun. All right, it's time to cut into this cutie. That's not a nightmare. That's a dream. I hope that this episode of Shut Your Cake Hole haunts your dreams. And if this haunted cake doll starts to talk to you in your dreams, you tell her for me. I said to shut your cake hole.